A 1.8 million-year-old skull has the science world all excited. That's because it might rewrite an early chapter in human evolution. Scientists have spent 8 years studying this fossil. It's the only complete skull from a hominin species from that time period, making it a big find for researchers. But the skull, nicknamed Skull 5, wasn't found alone. There were at least 4 other skulls at the site in Dmanisi, Georgia, and the individuals are thought to have died within a few hundred years of one another. When the researchers compared the specimens, they found a lot of variation in the shapes of the skulls, variation that might have led scientists to believe they found separate species if the fossils hadn't all been found in one place. The lead researcher says, since we see a similar pattern and range of variation in the African fossil record, it is sensible to assume that there was a single Homo species at that time in Africa. Catch that? He's saying that when scientists found skulls from what they thought were different species, like Homo ergaster, Homo rudolfensis, and Homo habilis, they were actually looking at members of one species, Homo erectus. That's a pretty big claim, one other scientist will need some time to warm up to. One tells NBC, "I think it's probably premature to dump everything into Homo erectus. This is what you're going to find the most opposition to." Another even criticized the group's methods to the BBC. They do a very general shape analysis of the cranium, which describes the shape of the face and brain case in broad, sweeping terms. The problem is that those Homo species are not defined using such a broad overview of what their general cranial shape is. So while scientists welcome the discovery of the remarkable Skull 5, the idea that they've been miscategorizing Homo fossils for a decade isn't going to sit very well. For now, scientists are making their familiar appeal. More research is needed. What all this screams out for is more and better specimens. We need skeletons, more complete material, so we can look at them from head to toe. Anytime a scientist says, "We've got this figured out," they are probably wrong. It's not the end of the story. For Newsy, I'm Candace Aviles.